Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Lion Plays the Binding of Isaac. We are at 338 items, 175 secrets. That might be all the secrets, maybe. I'm assuming there's 340 items. We're missing the soul and the mind, and honestly, I think that's it. Now, I know for a fact that the mind can show up in item rooms. It's just random here. I've heard that other streamers roll a D10 and then just, you know, exempt the loss so they can keep their streaks going. And then people go, wow, why do you care about the lost? Or, sorry, why do you care about your streak, Northern Lion? Well, because it's a little bit of a, you know, an EP just measuring contest. But at the same time, it's a fun thing to try to keep going. And it makes you more invested in every single run. If it's not just this run, it's like the... You know, the weight of the previous runs kind of rest on its shoulder. Admittedly, not that bad, I guess. Admittedly, a true streak would contain the lost. But I have a 25 true streak with the lost. I don't know. We'll see. First things first, let's just get all the items. FXY0 followed by VSPN. That is the Venezuelan Sports Production Network. Chris Berman works there now. You bullets? No, you become lumpy, I remember now. That is one of the most annoying enemies you could possibly face if your damage is so shitty that you actually just can't take him out in time. So let's... Dry Baby's really good. I'm gonna do this. It's not a good placement for that bomb. And I was hoping there'd be Spirit Hearts, and there were. And now, this is exactly what I was hoping for, is actually some fires. So we'll ruin our red hearts in order to put ourselves in Horror of Babylon and then protect ourselves like this. The reason I talked about are the items that we're missing is because I don't necessarily need... Shouldn't say that. For the mind, I don't necessarily need to go to Angel Room. So we can just play the game the way we would normally play the game. For the soul, I'm not sure. But at the very least, this run, we're just going to try to play it like normal. I'm not worried about the streak on this run. I'm just worried about streaking in general in the future. It's something I'd like to try. Some of the most fun that I've had. You know, I had some very average runs that turned into wins on that streak. But they felt like each one was, like, incredibly important. Because of the fact that there was, you know, the weight of the world on it from the 20x wins that came before. Anyway, we'll worry about that when it comes to it. Probably by the time I get real Platinum God and end up getting these last two items, the freaking... expansion will come out like the day before anyway. That's my hunch. Now we've got like the perfect Eve setup here. I've got to admit, you know, a nice little bit of Spirit Hearts protecting us. I was kind of hoping that would be Small Rock, but another Spirit Heart never hurt anybody, especially considering we're on the cellar right now. And we've got permanent Horror Babylon. We got Dry Baby, which is an adequate kind of utility item working in our favor. We got two keys for the next floor, and we also have a pretty easy boss here, even though it is a champion. It's going to be summoning the occasional double fly, but in the meantime, we're going to be able to sneak in an awful lot of damage against him in the interim period up here. He'll be dead. We don't seem to fight Duke of Flies all that often anymore. Don't pick that up. It's Jesus juice. This may be one of the few times where I can actually put my money where my mouth is, and if Placenta shows up, go, no, 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 no. I think Placenta is, like, a really cool idea for an item, and it's actually, like, potentially good, but as Eve in particular, it can be a real... ball buster, so we're gonna stay away from it. Thank you, dead bird. I did take a little stupid damage earlier on this floor. It's kind of hard to imagine that I would end up taking enough damage on this floor to lose my deal with the devil chance, but it's a theoretical possibility. Even if we don't fight the haunt, I've had some really, really terrible, like, brain stopped working. Had some really terrible spider and fly rooms. That was not worth the bomb, but we get piggy bank from our item room, and we have more keys in the future. We probably don't need those bombs right away. Piggy bank, I forgot there was a tinted rock back there. Piggy bank, I don't think I underrate it. I don't think I overrate it. I think I rate it pretty well, honestly. There are some items I'll admit I overrate. I'm trying to think of what it is, what they would be. We'll see when we come to them. I probably overrate Death's Touch a little bit. Even though for a while I thought I was underrating Death's Touch. Now I take it whenever it shows up just because it's a damage upgrade, but I probably end up overpaying for it a lot. That was maybe not the most pressing concern right there. What is wrong with me? I hate this room. I thought this is like two episodes ago I talked about hating this room, and yet it shows up time and time again, just to spite me. Why did I pick up red hearts? I don't like myself right now. It's alright, we're fighting Pin. Will it work? It did not work, but it came sort of close. Fighting Pin is not so bad. Should be a very easy boss fight, and we're guaranteed to deal with the devil, where hopefully I can trade all of our HP away. Or at least, even if we only trade away to the point where we get down to 1 HP, that'll be nice. I'm actually trying to do like some reverse Isaac's Heart bullshit here and try to ensure that Dry Baby actually does get hit. Doesn't seem to work like that. No, we gotta get it hit by a bullet or something. So Dry Baby gets hit by a bullet, then it'll do the Necronomicon effect, which should hit multiple segments of Pin, but to be honest with you, it doesn't really matter all that much in the whole scheme of things. Like, apparently explosions don't work for Dry Baby either. Range upgrade, not something I'm too fond of. Deal with the Devil is going to be Krampus. So me being a little bit mindless and accidentally picking up some HP is actually going to cost me semi-profusely here. But hopefully we end up just getting the Lump of Coal or Krampus's Head. I guess either of them is acceptable at this point. That is a very flatulent motorcycle outside. I apologize for the tacos and taquitos that it ate at 7-Eleven earlier today. That's not my fault, though. It's not my fault. At 5 minutes deep, I think we will... I hate this room. We got to piggyback in on that guy right there. We're going to take some time. We're going to try to find the shop. We're going to try to find the secret room. Because now I need to pick up some more damage because I'm a little bit of an idiot. And unfortunately, screwed myself. Slightly. That is the perfect opportunity for that. And two more keys for that is not really what I was looking for, but it is what it is. Inside of our shop, the blank card. Always a little bit of a gamble because blank card doesn't mean anything if you don't have any cards to go with it. Oh, okay. We'll take it. We'll probably take the spirit heart as well. Now, blank card, is it better than Krampus's head? It is the chance to be for sure. We'll take our spirit heart too. That worked out pretty well, and I'm excited to be leaving the floor. We only took like an extra 30 seconds there. But yes, I am a big dumb idiot who ruined my chances at Whore Babylon temporarily for basically no reason. I'm also going to check here very quickly for a secret room. All right. Time to go then. So we'll be, we'll be hoping to end up on Necropolis or the Depths. I think Necropolis might have more skulls, but we'll be hoping to get there as soon as possible. So that we can get, you know, as much skull action as is conceivable and get some sweet tarot cards. There's usually no shortage of skulls. Basically traded a bomb and a key for 2 bombs and 2 cents. Not an incredible trade. I can live with it, though. Not too worried about boss rush, although, you know, the same rules do apply. Like, the faster or the more often we get boss rush, the more likely we are to get those items that we need as quickly as possible. Pretty much... straight up the worst boss trap room that you could possibly anticipate there. But that's okay. I wish that Dry Baby did take damage or activated when it got hit by things that were not bullets. It might be a little bit too easy to scum it, but man, that would be so cool. Like, look at this, like get one of these silkworms to walk into it, boom. All enemies dead. Wouldn't be easy, would still have like a pretty high skill cap associated with it. It is pretty close to you. Alright, that'll just simplify this ever so slightly. I can't believe that our damage is so bad because I got out of that Whore Babylon state that I can't even kill more than one of these guys every time they get knocked down. This is embarrassing. Entirely my own fault, but embarrassing nonetheless. Yeah, good damage there. That was really smart. What we may want to do here, actually... I forgot that wasn't the last wave. What we may want to do here, actually, this is like the coward's way out, but if we find another Spirit Heart, like on our shop, for example... we may want to actually hurt ourselves to the point where we get back into Whore Babylon state, then pick up that Spirit Heart and get on with it, because, sincerely, this is real annoying. What the heck? Dry Baby, it's getting hit, but it must have, like, an activated, like, refractory period or something like that. Oh, there we go. Does it pop, like, its arms out or something? How are you not deceased? There we go. Seriously? Well, I would maybe kiss boss rush goodbye a little bit. Wonderful. We're slow. It's entirely my own fault. Well, it's my own fault and the fault of the Devil Room for giving us Krampus's head instead of Lump of Coal. I can feel myself tilting a little bit. That's probably cue for me to take a little bit of a break after this episode. But for now, stop tilting. We're going to right the ship. Everything's going fine, baby. You got Dry Baby. You got some good stuff going on here. All you gotta do is not throw it. Easier said than done, you know? These bonies are no laughing matter. Thank you, Dry Baby. You saved my ass there. I appreciate that. All we gotta do is not tilt super hard. And if we don't get a deal with the devil on this floor, it doesn't really matter all that much. There is a spirit heart here. So I'm gonna bomb myself, get into the Whore of Babylon state. It's risky, but I think it's smart, and bought that spirit heart. I'm gonna buy a black candle as well. The evil upgrade protects us a little bit more, and also we don't have to worry about curses anymore. Curses can be quite annoying. So we should have still a pretty good chance of a deal with the devil and or angel here. Could be either, because we don't have a deal with the devil precedent. I don't believe, at least, that taking Krampus's head counts as a deal with the devil precedent. I hope it does, so we don't get a deal with the angel, but you can't always get what you want. There's a bomb for free. Little Gish is fine, and honestly, I feel like I've righted the ship a little bit here. It seems a little bit strange, the way that I did that, but I do think it was the right decision, and I think I feel better about this run already. The potential, turns out, was inside of us all along. Red becomes dead, becomes red hearts, becomes... We can pick that up. All right. We're at 9 minutes. We're actually not going that slowly for the lack of damage we had earlier. Let's see what we're going up against here. Peep. Kind of a middling boss in terms of difficulty, I'd say, for this point in the game. It'll become immune to slows temporarily, but that's fine. Bounce back and forth here. That was not good dodging on my part, but I guess on the bright side, we do have Dead Bird doing its action now, doing its dirty work. Bad time for a slow, actually. This would be a great time for a deal with the devil. I could totally take, like, a ceremonial robes or something like that. Put myself in guaranteed Whore of Babylon state with a little bit more protection. I would feel so good about it. Well, instead, we get a range upgrade and nothing else, but I'm still, like, in a way, Whore of Babylon actually being activated feels new to me, so I feel like we did still get a damage upgrade there, one way or the other. Red chests. Probably not gonna take too much of an opportunity to take advantage of either of these, if I had to guess, but we'll see. One bomb for 6 cents seems like a pretty good deal for us. We might have been able to actually get 7 out of that. I'm not sure if you could put the bomb far enough away to actually get that one as well. But it's not that big of a deal. I love Dry Baby just when you think you're in a tough spot. It comes in and helps you out a little bit. That is a double key room. Do I want to reroll my whole run? Probably not. In that case, do I want to spend 2 keys on this when I only have 3? Probably not. Probably say no to that just for now. If we get more keys, we could go back. Hagala's rune. I'm not going to use it here. I'd rather use it on a room that has... Very, very stupid of me there. I'd rather use it on a room that has mushrooms we can actually, like, get. There's only 2 mushrooms or something that we can get there. Converter. We actually want things to work in the opposite way. Does blank card allow us to use runes? Oh, it totally does. So we just got magic mushroom for free. Save me. I love getting magic mushroom for free. It is going to give us more HP, though, which I didn't want. But we have a blood bank. Okay, all is forgiven. That was the best Hagala's rune of all time, then. That is exceptionally useful. So we'll take ourselves low here. I shouldn't have picked up that heart just in case it pays out too early. Don't pay out. Don't pay out. One more. Yes. Okay. All right. So again, we almost snatched a defeat from the jaws of victory, but we pulled it back here. We're going to be at about maybe 15 minutes when we finish this, which does give us a small crack at boss rush. Not a large one, but a small one. And that's all we need, because again, all we need to do is walk in and be like, these aren't the items we're looking for, and then we can walk out if we don't want them. So we can use the Hagala's rune once every 4 rooms. Actually, you know, as much as I have never really liked the Hagala's rune, admittedly, I'm in a bit of a honeymoon period with it right now because of that magic mushroom pickup, but the fact that we can use it once every 4 rooms actually almost makes it useful just due to the sheer law of large numbers here, I think. Like, we can come back here, for example, and be like, okay, we can get, like, 4 mushrooms just by trying this. We got hurt in the process. That was not a very smart decision on my part. All right. Were there spirit arts for sale in that shop? Because I'm starting to get a little worried about that. Don't die on this run. There's no spirit arts for sale. There's the opposite of spirit hearts. You know what? I'll pay 5 cents for that. Bit of an unusual one here. It happens. Check for a secret room quickly. That's okay. I think we'll las the shit out of this Haga. Doesn't really make any sense. Got one pill. Just tears up. That was lovely. I would never have spent, like, any bombs blowing those up. So these are all profit for me right now. There's a tinted rock just right over there. Right over there. All we gotta do is get to it. Please be spirit hearts. Okay, that's also great. I think I'm gonna take it right away because I could use the extra eternal heart as, like, as insulation, basically. And we're lucky enough to be fighting a very easy boss here. So this is a huge pickup for us. This is potentially a really, really big floor. But I will lose my Whore of Babylon on the next floor because of that Eternal Heart. And we got to deal with the Angel. What are you going to give me here? Oh, that's the Soul. So at the very least, we've got something of value on this run. You know what? You're going to hate me for this. I'm going to lose this Eternal Heart so that I don't lose Whore of Babylon. If we're going to do that, we might as well... you know, go for broke and take as many hearts into it as we can here. Goodbye, Eternal Heart. I did get the ability to fly out of fate nonetheless. And then we got the Soul. I believe the Soul, it repels enemy bullets, which might make it terrible with Dry Baby, but maybe we should be focusing on the Soul instead of focusing on Dry Baby. At the very least, we can celebrate a little bit, because this means we only have one item left to get a real Platinum God, I think, and that item would be the Mind. So there you go. It enters the Pantheon. The first item that I needed in order to get first Platinum God was Parasite. Then when Wrath of the Lamb came out, I needed to get, or was Wrath of the Lamb Parasite? Now I can't remember. It's been too long. What do you think here? Hagalaz or Justice? I kind of think Hagalaz is a little bit more interesting. I can't remember now. It's been so long. But it's going to be the Mind for Rebirth. I know Mom's Knife was like the second to last item that we needed on one of them, which was really funny. Because then it showed up on, like, every run after that for all time. We'll just wait on Hagalaz, I guess, to use that. We've got Skulls showing up now. Do we know pills? We know some pills. Amnesia's not very good. I mean, the game is fine. Lockdown, that's not very good. I mean, the game's fine. We are at 14 and a half minutes. I honestly think Boss Rush is very, very likely. I don't know what the Mind looks like. Common questions of, you know, philosophy and whatnot. Hagalaz almost ready. There are no skulls on this room. No skulls in the champagne room either. Where's your friend? There is your friend. Good, good, good. Golden keys. I like it. We got a... oh, you know. I know. So we're going to take, I know Hagalaz could be more useful, but we're going to take the Fool card because of the boss rush potential. Basically being able to snag a free item from the boss rush room is worth more than saving a lot of bombs and getting some cracks and stuff. If we could take, if we could have starter deck on this floor, I would take Hagalaz with me in a heartbeat. I liked it. And this is the first time that I've ever really experienced the usefulness of that item. It required, again, kind of like a law of large numbers thing going on, but that's okay. At least now I know in the future, hey, we got a Hagalaz rune. Use it on a room full of mushrooms. Those are the things most likely to pay out with good stuff that you wouldn't have blown up anyway. And I will blow up these skulls, because again, they can give me even better tarot cards. Or they can just pay out with, you know, big old jerk holes. Jerk holes, by the way, my favorite website on the internet. Probably don't Google it. It probably does exist now that I think about it. Of course it does. It's the internet. Okay, you're going to be easy to take out. You're going to be even easier, because I said so. Just buy the Spirit Heart. Could buy the key as well. 16 minutes, so we're going to have to be fast. We haven't been to our item room yet. We're going to have to be pretty fast. Not the fastest we've ever been, but pretty dang quick if we're going to get this boss rush, which I would really, really love to do now. Piggy bank. You could probably calculate how much money Piggy Bank's given me over the course of this run, but when you pick it up, you go like, ugh, Piggy Bank, and then you realize, oh shit, Piggy Bank paid me like 50 cents over the course of this run. That's pretty solid. If you got a dollar in that room, you'd be like, oh, snap, a dollar, free shops for the rest of the game. Piggy Bank pays out, you know, more slowly as opposed to a lump sum, and I think gets less respect as a result. Are we gonna skip the item room on this floor? Yes. Yes, we are. I hate the idea of doing it. Maybe we'll get something awesome on our angel room that'll make me... Or something awesome right here. That'll make me feel like we can afford to spend the time to go back. But I basically see our boss rush as like four item rooms and we choose the best one. So I was like, well, I don't want to miss our chance to pick up the item we're missing, the mind. But we'll have a better chance to pick it up on the boss rush room, I think. And we don't even have to fight for it, which is even better. Guppy's collar for free. It's fine. I didn't mean to place a bomb there, by the way. We'll move along here. Good run thus far. I still have not really paid attention to what the soul has done for us, I suppose. I was just happy to have got... It's just like adding another... It's like if you had to complete your collection of Pokemon cards, and the last card you needed was like a Metapod. You're not being like, oh, fuck, Metapod. Shit, yeah, I'm going to use Harden all over you bitches. Nah, you're just like, okay, I got Metapod. My collection's done. Or done, sorry. Now let's go back to playing with, you know, Charizard. Even though Blastoise is the cool one. We're going to have about like a minute and a half to get to our boss room soon. That scares me. But again, even if this run goes terribly wrong, we did what we needed to do. What is going on here? And by do what we needed to do, what I'm basically getting at is we got an item. If we can keep getting one item per run, it's not going to take us very long at all to get the Platinum God. They're very close. This guy in particular. This is not the right time to go in the wrong direction. Okay, there's another key inside of our shop. I did not want to fight you, Greed. You know what? I know there's a tinted... That was weird. I know there was a tinted rock there. I said no. I said, you've fucked me long and hard enough. We're not doing this. Okay, now I could die in one hit. Here's... Okay, thank you, Monkey's Paw. One of the very few times that Monkey's Paw has proved itself as an extremely worthy item. Thank you. Maybe some black hearts here. Lovers. Don't want it. Gotta stay strong. What is this shit curse room over here? Are you kidding me? I'm starting to think we're not gonna be able to do this. We're not gonna have enough time. What a crazy roundabout layout for this room. Oh my god, I gotta be able to hit the enemies in order to do anything here. Okay, good. 19, 15. I think we gotta go into this item room just because it's fast. You know, it's right here. Hopefully it's on the way to the boss. If it's not, we're fucked anyway. Broken mirror. Yeah, sure. Oh my god, take it. 30 seconds is enough time. Anything less than that, we're cutting it pretty close. Oh, it's the wrong direction. It becomes less and less conceivable as time goes on. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, crap. Okay, well, you're not gonna do it. So just get the fucking Blackheart, man! Thank you, okay. You've lost it, alright? You were just a little bit too slow, and that's fine. There's no boss rush coming, so why don't you just play it cool here? Why don't you just relax a little bit? Hey, what's done is done. We've missed out on it. Life goes on. Let's go play this Demon Judgment. I have to talk in that soothing tone, otherwise I don't know what I'm going to do here. Because I thought I gave myself a pretty good chance there. We're trying to find a secret room. We're going to play this Demon Judgment, though. Gonna open up all these chests that we missed out on, get those luck down pills that are really pivotal to our run right now. Okay. Lover's card, that's good for now. And we only have one bomb left. Let's throw it down here. I have faith. Ooh. Okay, once every four rooms, a Bracano rune might actually be best for us, actually. Goathead is fine here. We will get a deal with the devil after this, so we'll fool a card out. Then we're going back up, and we're picking up once every four rooms Bracano or once every four rooms Lovers. I don't think we want Lovers. I think we want Bracano. Where's our Demon Judgments? Not up here? Because the Bracano rune gives us three flies, three spiders. It's pretty good damage. And we can use this Demon Judgment to stay in our Whore of Babylon state. Come on, you gotta pay out with something here. We put in the time. There's no words on it. There's no other red hearts. There is, oh, we didn't even go to our shop. So we should probably go to our shop. That's probably a pretty good idea for an adult to do. It's an adult decision. All right, contract from below is great. Well, we've already had a deal with the angel, so maybe we'll just keep getting deals with the angel. And that'll allow us a better chance to pick up the mind, because I do think it's in that pool as well. What do we have here? 5 is forget me now. Are you kidding? Oh, I remember now. We walked in here and we said, fudge you, Tony, I think, and we walked out. Gonna use the Bracano rune after this room. We don't have any bombs to blow up that Tinted Rock. Super Greed is playing me like a damn fiddle right now. Well, we could probably buy... Oh, let's think things through before you say it. We could probably buy a bomb on our shop. Well, at least we got one, plus a golden key, which is worthless right now. Hematemesis is actually, like, pretty good for the future. And that's also great for right now. I don't think we want to forget this room. Because that... Let's do it. Could be fun. It's gonna be ridiculous anyway. We could have maybe taken the Fool card out or something like that, but whatever. This is fine. So let's start using this Bracano rune. Let's see what it's really got. I don't think... I mean, we witnessed that. I don't think this run is really strong enough to have a great chance. Well, I think it might have a good chance, but... It's not really strong enough for me to feel super confident in a victory right now, so... I guess every floor, every extra item room, every extra shop and mini-boss that we fight is good. And especially, like, doing one more floor with contract from below seems pretty smart, if you ask me. So we've got, like, a slightly shittier version of, like, a combined Guppy's Head and Box of Spiders here. It's weird. It's not the rune that, you know, I would prefer to be rolling with if we had the option to choose. But it was either this or the Lover's card, and I don't even want the HP, so we'll just get a little ridiculous here. And if we get the mind, I will feel so vindicated in our choice to actually go through one more floor. Plus, I mean, the enemies that we're fighting should be relatively easy. I mean, it's the second time we're fighting them. Thank you, Dry Baby. Not really interested in that. Am quite interested in what goes on in this shop here. No greed, please. This is not greed. It's Pandora's Box. Pandora's Box is not great for us right now. I will take the Bible so that we won't get the Bible in the future. I will take Pandora's Box and use it just to get the cash back that we just spent. I think you get 20 cents and we spent 15. So how do you like that action right there, bad boy? Why am I picking this up? Got a lot of blood banks on this floor. I don't know what I'm looking for, but we're gonna get it. Yeah, like, I don't want to pay out with the blood bag. Oh, well. We did it. We made some money, and that was entirely fiscally motivated decisions on this floor thus far. Where's our pins at? Ah, okay. Did we have slow at this point on the last run? On the last floor, I should say. I can't remember. Good, you know, mental math for when that pin would be dead. Good stuff. Item room and shop, I'm assuming, are going to be in this general direction over here. I hate when I spend, like, 30 seconds shooting an enemy. Wasn't 30 seconds, obviously. But then the AI bomb just comes in and blows the shit up. It's like, what was I even there for? Why don't you give me your artillery tables next time so we don't end up making this mistake again and again? This is not a library. 2 of clubs. Stars and death. Every 4 rooms having a death card is probably a little bit better than Bracano. But what about every 4 rooms having a Joker card? That seems even better. There are even better ones than this for blank card, by the way. Because the only reason I'm going to be doing this is because we can use this to get early deals with the devil and guaranteed deals with the devil. We already have Goathead. And we can get a deal with the devil on... Oh, that's pretty good. We can get a deal with the devil on the... Cathedral, which would otherwise be unlikely unless we just found a Joker card randomly. And the chest, I suppose. We can get a Joker on the chest. Or deal with the devil on the chest. See what we get there. That might glitch our game and cause us to die, though. This is a very weird run. Like, not cause us to die, but cause us to be, like, stuck in the devil room and not able to get out. I don't know. kind of things sometimes you think about in Isaac. Very weird run, but I am very, very happy with our decision to come back here. The Bracano rune, I'm going to be honest with you, wasn't really holding it down, so I don't feel bad about our decision to get rid of it, but it is an okay, you know, one-off rune, especially if you're dealing more damage, which we were not until semi-recently. If you're not going to go to boss rush, this is how you travel in style, I guess. So, we are going to go to the chest, because I want the maximum chance to get these items. We just got Sacred Heart for free, which is amazing, and now I cannot complain any further. We are at full health now, but we did just get Sacred Heart. Hopefully I find a way to trade all of our HP away, but even if we don't, our damage should be through the roof right now. Joker card will give us 3 Spirit Hearts. Not really what I was looking for there. There is still value in the Joker card, though. What's up with these... Oh, my reflection Sacred Heart is actually terrible. Good to know. Hoping for a free Guppy item. Don't get your hopes up too high. The other reason that I like having the Joker card is we can teleport. So what we should have done is probably just walked out of this room, or walked into this room with a teleport ready and just walked away. Instead, what we're going to do is fight all these enemies, which I don't love the idea of, because as you can see, Sacred Heart, my reflection, is apparently terrible. The damage is worth the bullshit that you have to deal with here, but the bullshit is annoying. And our deal with the angel sucked on this floor. I think we're better off with Monkey's Paw. Judas Tongue is unlikely to work. So the next time we're going to be able to use the Joker card super effectively, hopefully, is going to be on the Cathedral. It's a little bit of a trip. Maybe we'll get a Yara rune before that, and we'll find something to replace the Joker card with. But we can still teleport out of curse rooms and stuff like that. Although it will teleport back into curse rooms. Yeah. So we'll still have to take damage on the way out. You can really only use it for mob and boss trap rooms, which are basically the same thing now. What could I possibly... You know what I'm hoping for now is Guppy's Paw. Not just so we can become Guppy, because we can get that Whore of Babylon effect, which I'm missing it a little bit. I got to admit, you know, Sacred Heart's lovely and all that, but I am missing the Whore of Babylon effect a little bit, because they would work so nicely in concert with one another. And mind you, we do have money equals power. That's lovely. Everyone's happy. Money equals power. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We can get a little bit of extra leverage with Sacred Heart just by, you know, pushing off before we attack. It would be better if we had Lump of Coal, because we're, you know, doing a lot of kind of like revolving stuff here. Oscillating shots. Other such nonsense. Careful. Wall masters are real. Lots of dead ends. Loving that. Again, if we Joker card, I'm pretty sure we just come back right in here, so it's kind of not worth it. It's not worth it to really fight for it either. Kind of wishing I had some Bracano rune action now that I got Sacred Heart. We might as well pick that up. If I didn't, that would be very silly because I have the damage from money equals power. Plus, it takes us to 69 cents, the magic number. The good news is if we play creatively, we can kind of throw up a shield for ourselves here. You know, just throw up a bunch of bullets and then come back down. Make some enemies a lot less useful. But I'm feeling the heat, man. I want Guppy's Paw. Ooh. Okay, you know what? I'm going to stick with the Joker card, but I'll double up on these Bracanos right now. I appreciate a game. I could have used a third one, actually, if I wanted to. I mean, they're doing some real damage. Maybe we were better off going with Bracano, but, you know, it's better to have Bracanoed and lost than never Bracanoed at all. That's what I've always thought. Tears Up is good. I can't believe that I think we're only one item away from actually getting real Platinum God. It's quite exciting. Awaz rune. Black Market. Oh, snap! It is a Black Market. We also got the Hierophant. I'm about to do something very dumb, I think. Okay, let's go to the Black Market first, because it could be like a real Black Market. It's not. It's an HP upgrade. I don't even want this, to be honest with you. So here's what I'm going to do. We only have 9 bombs. I'm going to find like some... Oh, there's a spike right in the center of the room. We can even get some kind of payout here. I'm going to hurt the shit out of myself. We're going to get so much money, and so much money equals power as a result of this. I don't want those hearts here. So we're going to take a big gamble Just to get Whore of Babylon active. Now I'm just focusing here. And we want to get to a half heart. So there we go. That gave us a black heart from Monkey's Paw and also permanent Polaroid invincibility. Now we grab our Hierophant. And we just start bashing the shit out of it with blank cards. We're probably going to say Joker. It's been fun, but no thank you. And we're going to take our newfound style down here because this is going to give us so much more damage. Now, it's risky. All good things in life are. Well, that's not true. Nothing risky about a, you know, Big Mac. Nothing risky about buying into the bond market. But I think this is the right decision because now we're going to just shit on, like, all enemies. And I'm probably going to take a lot less damage because the tiers that I have are actually going to be doing as much damage as I would expect that they'd be doing. Which works out better for me. Pageant Boy. Ooh la la. That's actually not so bad for us. It's not so good either, but... And then we'll blank card our Hierophant card and move along. Goodbye, Joker. It's been fun. Down to the next floor. And we're going to miss out on that deal with the devil on... the cathedral, but I would have been hoping for something that would have given us more damage, and this has given us more damage. The reason I didn't want to take any more, or I didn't want to take that HP upgrade that we got for free is because it would have compromised our ability to get more spirit hearts. There's a tinted rock here. Which would have been bad. I like being able to get as close to the HP maximum as possible. That was very, very close. How are you not dead? Like, just be real with me right here. Health up. At least it doesn't give us the actual, the red hearts to fill it up. This is going a lot better now. There's our Hierophant card. We're at max HP. It's not, just because we're at max HP doesn't mean it's worthless to use the Hierophant, because unlike Balls of Steel, it actually deposits the, HP on the ground, which means we can use it for the future. It's a good thing. We can stack up HP on a floor and use it whenever it's necessary. It's more HP upgrades, I think. We definitely do not want those. Each one of those makes our Hierophant situation here slightly worse. Come on, Guppy's Paw. Sets us up much more nicely than we are right now, but this is still, this is fine. We are one-shotting pretty much every enemy that we face. I should have saved the Hierophant for the next floor, actually, but it's fine. What's done is done. If we take damage, we can just pick up this stuff right away. Alright, the damage is adequate. The thing is, the shots, they kind of, they try to my reflect back, but they don't really do a good job of it. We'll be picking up the spirit heart and going down to the next floor. They don't really do a good job of it, going up to the next floor, I should say. Because they want to get, like, sucked into the heart. They want to go to their target, so the range is, like, it's either a weird non-issue, or it is holding me back, but I'm not maybe experiencing it that much, thankfully. I saw some bullets actually deflect away from us there as a result of the soul, so... I guess that must be what the item does, whether... it hit me and just one of them bounced off. I was just standing there for dramatic effect, I swear. We want to stay at a half heart, because that gives us the benefit of the permanent Polaroid invincibility. The easiest way to totally blow this run right now is to pick up a half heart on the ground, or a full heart for that matter, but... picking up any kind of HP that is not black or blue is an incredibly dumb decision for me right now. Yeah, you know, I'll fight for Gemini. I don't know if Gemini's damage is based on my damage. Don't pick up that heart. No, 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 no. Don't funk with that heart. I don't know why I've been making a lot of don't funk with my heart references lately. Probably because this is the greatest song ever written in American pop music. Don't pick up that heart either. It's very tempting. Yes. With 16 keys, unless we get a... Okay. With 14 keys, unless we got a Yera rune. That's something you should watch out for. The Emperor. You know what? Sure. Let's use... We don't even need to use the Hierophant. I'm just going to go pick up the Spirit Heart, use the blank card, go down to the next floor, use the Emperor card. It's kind of a shortcut, but it's a shortcut that works very well for us. I don't know why it's taken forever for blank card to actually work now. I don't know. Did it always do that? I don't think so. Well, it took some real damage there, but we can get up in his butt now. Shots are doing some wild stuff thanks to the soul. Yeah, we're safe here. Alright, so we took a little damage. We should have used the Hero Font card first, but we're not going to go back for it anyway, so there was kind of like no way to swing this more properly. And we do have the chance to come back to life with Guppy's collar. I hope we don't have to use it. So it's down to the next floor. Anything we can get that ups our damage without giving us more HP. I don't want your HP. Speedball. Celtic Cross. Monstro's Lung. I like butt bombs. I'll take Monstro's Lung. I think Monstro's Lung is a cool item. I'll take Celtic Cross for maybe a little extra invincibility. That's not going to work out too well. I think our shots are going to be extremely potent, so let's try this out. Yeah, that's... they're doing their job. This is going to be easy. What a weird kind of finish to this run. And it was just a weird run in general, but we made it work. We got one more item. Excuse me, let me go down here. We continued our streak. Mission accomplished. As you can see, we're at 338 items. Wait, we must have had this soul before then. Anyway, it's new to me. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.